Hello viewers, a very warm welcome to my channel, and today's recipe is rose panna cotta with homemade rose syrup. And it is a very easy recipe and a very easy dessert. For that, I am going to show you first how you can make rose syrup at home. You may get some in the market with a very high price, but here I will be showing you a low cost syrup, rose syrup, which you can make easily at your home, and I will also show you how you can preserve it for a longer time. So let's check it out. So let's make the syrup first. For that, I'm taking a pan on a heat, and into this I'm adding 2 cups of water. Higher the flame, and now I'm going to add 1 cup of sugar to this water and let the sugar be melted in this water. The sugar is being melted, and now I'm going to add 1 cupful of dried rose petals. I have shared a link in the description box where you can get these rose petals. And after adding this, you will find the water become bluish, but not to worry. After boiling for some time, you will find the water will become red. Now you can see, after boiling for some time, the water or the syrup became red, and that's what we exactly need. And I'm adding few drops of rose essence. Water is almost reduced to 1 cup, and I'm now adding 2 teaspoons of honey to it. Honey will actually increase its shelf life, and you can preserve it for a longer time, and it will provide some kind of stickiness to the syrup. Now let it come to a boil for a last time, and off goes the flame, and the syrup is ready. For the checking whether the syrup is ready, just take few drops between your fingers and your fingers will feel sticky. So you may say the syrup is ready. Now I'm going to strain it with a strainer, and for that I am taking a large bowl, and into this I am straining it, and with the help of a spatula just squeeze out all the syrup from the petals. The color which arrived in the syrup is absolutely natural, and I don't feel to add any kind of artificial color to it, but I have to cool it down completely, and then I have to check it whether the color remains the same or not. You may or may not add the food colors, and now I'm going to cool it down. After cooling down, I will be storing it in a sterile glass jar. I always recommend to store these kind of things in a glass jar rather than plastic jars. This is the final look of the rose syrup, and it is exactly look like market bought rose syrup, and I have added few drops of red food color, but you can absolutely avoid it and keep it in the refrigerator. For making panna cotta, you will need water and gelatin. So here is a 1/2 cup of water. Into this I am adding 2 teaspoons of wet gelatin, and now with the help of a spoon I am mixing it and let it rest for at least 10 minutes to bloom. Let me quickly show you the other ingredients. This is fresh cream or thick cream, sugar, and rose essence. I am using the silicone molds, the rose silicone molds, to set the dessert, but you can use anything else. Now again I'm placing a pan on heat, and into this I'm adding the thick cream. The thick cream is already added with some water. You can use milk as well instead of water. Now let it melt, or just let it come to a boil, but stir it continuously, otherwise it will stick to the pan. I'm adding the sugar and let it melt in this cream. Now as the cream is very thick, it may stick to the sides of the pan, so you have to scrape it and bring it to the center and stir it continuously. Now I am going to add few drops of rose essence to it and mix it well. You don't have to let it come to a full boil, so I am keeping the flame low. And now I am going to add the rose syrup. I am adding 2 teaspoons of rose syrup to this. You may add more according to your taste. And now I am going to mix it well, and here off goes the flame. Now I am adding the bloomed gelatin. You can see the gelatin has come to a jellified look, and I am adding this to it. Make sure the flame is off, and now I am going to strain it in a strainer to avoid the lumps to be going in. Now immediately after, I have to arrange it in the molds. So here I have already arranged the molds in the tray, and now I am adding it hurriedly in these molds, because once the gelatin is added to the cream, it will start concentrating immediately. So keep the mold ready first and then add the gelatin to cream or any kind of liquid. So here all the 5 molds are done. Now I am going to let it cool down first and then put it in the refrigerator. You will need to put it in the refrigerator for at least 2 hours. This dessert can be set in any kind of utensils, whether it is glass bowls or steel bowls or anything else which is easily available at your household. Now I am setting the rest of the cream in the glass bowls. So this is also ready to going in the refrigerator. After coming to room temperature, I am adding once again this rose syrup on the top just to enhance the flavor of the rose. But this is optional, you can skip this. Now I am going to put it in the refrigerator. It's been 2 hours and I brought out this. First, I'm showing you this. I'm flipping over on a plate and it came out so easily and nicely set. You can see that. You can decorate it with the dried rose petals. And now I brought out the silicone molds also. Now I'm going to demold this like this on a plate. One by one, and you will find how easily it will come out. Very nice rose shape has arrived due to the molds, and the dessert is ready to serve. Subscribe this channel if you like this video. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you may get updated about newly uploaded food videos on my channel. Thanks for watching.